Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, I'm going to answer the question of how do I actually share a pre-composed look of a report, like a slicer, and then share that with my executive team because personal bookmarks can't be shared. I got you covered. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, personal bookmarks can't be shared, and I've actually had some conversations with customers where they want to do exactly that. I want to craft or slice a report a certain way or have it look and drill down into a specific item and share that off with like my executive leadership team, right? Maybe the CFO of your company wants to just look at the report, doesn't want to waste time clicking around trying to find the answer. They just want to quickly look at what is relevant to them. Personal bookmarks can't be shared. So what do you do? Aha. If all this talking, let's head over to my machine and actually see what our options are. So I've got an app. This works both for just a regular report in a workspace or a published app. It still relies on the fact that the person has to have the right access to the content, but assuming that is the case, one thing we can do here, let's say I want to spotlight this table. So when they come into the report, that's what I want them to see. One thing we'll notice here, if I grab the URL and we come over to my editor of choice, which is trusty Notepad, we'll see that there's a bookmark GUID attached to it. So that's awesome. It's the very end of the URL. And that indicates to me that, well, wait a second, there's a bookmark that gets generated as part of this. So let's just try and copy this and run this as the other user. So assume that I'm just sending an email and the link is there. So let's go in. I'm now in my John Doe account. John Doe has access to the app and we'll just put that in, see what happens. It brings up the app and says, oh no, that bookmark isn't available. Oh no, what do we do? That's okay. So this is our direct URL, right? So direct URL does not work in this situation. So I can't just share the URL directly. Okay, so this is when most people are like, okay, well, in this case, I'm just gonna create my personal bookmark. So here I have a personal bookmark already created. So let's click on that. And when we do that, we'll get another URL and it will also have a bookmark GUID as part of it. But one thing you'll notice is the bookmark GUID is different. This is because we're using the personal bookmark. So let's go ahead and do this and we'll do the same thing, right? Let's see what happens when we try and share this URL. So we'll come back to Mr. John Doe and we'll run that. Same thing. Bookmark's not available. So frustrating. But wait, just a little insight into how Patrick and I figure out what we want to do in these videos. This actually happened when I was talking to Chris Hamill over Teams and he did a certain action. And when he did that, like it worked, like it shared the bookmark state. And I'm like, what? That's like an awesome workaround to not being able to share personal bookmarks. So let me show you what he did. Same scenario, same report. Let's go back. So this is my login, right? So, and I've got my spotlight here. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna hit chat in Teams. And when you do that, it will give you a URL. Now, if I just copy this URL, so I don't actually have to do the Teams action, but just copying that URL, let's go over here. We'll see it's got some other items as well, but it also has a bookmark GUID as part of it. And there's something magical about this URL. If I go to John Doe and we go put that URL in, bam, the bookmark is there. My spotlight is on the visual, everything transferred over. What? That's amazing, right? So if you're in a scenario where you want to share a personal bookmark, try the chat in Teams instead. It's a great workaround to accomplish the same task. So now I can do chat in Teams, grab that URL, and when I send my email or whatever to the executive or whoever I want to share it with, I'll say, hey, check out this report and put a hyperlink for this report that goes to the URL with that bookmark that was crafted in the chat in Teams, and bam, they will get exactly what it was that you wanted to show them. That's amazing. Just a quick tip, something I noticed, and I wanted to share that off with you. Let me know what your thoughts are. Leave them in the comments below and tell me if you know of another way that you can do this or what you're doing to work around that particular scenario. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.